my name is Tim Gravel. I'm a registered nurse and a family nurse practitioner student at Auburn University. I'm addressing you today, state legislators of Georgia, about an issue concerning sugar-sweetened beverages. First, I'd like to define the issue regarding sugar-sweetened beverages and then explain to you a proposed plan and a budgeting plan for that as well. Sugar-sweetened beverages are any beverage that has added sugars. Typically, we think of sodas, but this also includes your coffee, sweetened teas, and even your sports drinks. Sugar-sweetened beverages are the leading source of added sugars in the American diet, with the average soda containing approximately 130 calories. The American Heart Association recommends between 100 to 150 calories of intake from added sugars daily. As you can see, it's very easy to overconsume sugar-sweetened beverages, as one sugar-sweetened beverage exceeds the 100 to 150 calorie intake daily. Surprisingly, 63% of our youth reported having at least one sugar-sweetened beverage a day, and then that drops down to 49% in adults. The major issue with the sugar-sweetened beverage consumption is that it is associated with the development of obesity, heart disease, and type 2 diabetes, all things that we as healthcare providers are concerned for the American population. Vulnerable populations with sugar-sweetened beverages include those from lower socioeconomic statuses, lower income, and lower educational backgrounds. Programs such as SNAP, which is the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, have been developed to help these low socioeconomic classes. This program provides assistance by offering a card from which people can purchase groceries. The issue is that there's no definition of what groceries can and can't be bought. And in fact, $2.1 billion were spent purchasing sugar-sweetened beverages in a one-year time span. If we're offering supplemental nutrition and it's coming from the taxpayer's dollar, you would think that it would be best to provide something sustainable and not something that can lead to the disease progression and disease development of obesity, diabetes, and heart disease. My proposition today is to ask legislators to help with the development of a bill that can define the usage of the SNAP program and eliminate the ability to buy sugar-sweetened beverages through this program, and to also place a warning label directly on sugar-sweetened beverages. As healthcare providers can provide a lot of education to their patients, but it's difficult to reach everybody. And a warning label is a great way to reach anybody who picks up any sugar-sweetened beverage. Organizations such as Kick the Can have helped produce warning labels that have been used and developed and put into law in states such as Washington, Maryland, New York, and even California. I'd like to raise awareness and provide education through the use of fundraisers, as well as the development of a video which will be placed on a Facebook page to best reach the masses. Together, I think that we can do what other states have done and reduce the usage of sugar-sweetened beverages, which will in long term help reduce the development of diseases such as obesity, type 2 diabetes, and heart disease. Thank you for your consideration.